Welcome to Institute of Quality and Reliability. Hi, this is Hemant Urdhvarishi. In this video, we will explain how to predict reliability using Monte Carlo simulation. This method can be applied when load and strength both can be modeled using a known distribution. In the previous video, we have seen the deterministic approach to design when the designers consider strength and load as single points or single values. And we have also seen the factor of safety, and we have also seen the design margins. But we have also seen that the reality is actually different, and both strength and stress vary because of many factors. So we need to use other distribution models. The other distributions include lognormal, Weibull, and many other distributions. These can be modeled using software such as Simular, as we will see in the later part of this video. In wind turbines, the load on the blades will vary significantly based on the wind velocity at that location. Sometimes the wind velocity is modeled using Weibull distribution. Also, the strength of the turbine blades can vary because of the resin configuration or reinforcement and many other factors. Similarly, in elevators, the load can vary because of the upward and downward movement of the elevator and the number of passengers that are using the elevator. Also, the strength of the ropes may not remain same because of the corrosion and fatigue of the ropes. Therefore, such problems may require solutions by using Monte Carlo simulation. The Monte Carlo simulation techniques are widely used not only in reliability but also in industrial engineering, finance, and many other applications. In Monte Carlo simulation, large number of values of system performance are generated using random numbers based on assumed distribution model. Repeated calculations of design performance are made using randomly generated or simulated values based on the probability distributions that describe each element of the model. Monte Carlo simulation does not require complex mathematical calculations, but it requires excessive use of computer time. Typically, the number of simulations may be more than 10,000. Predictability of Monte Carlo simulations depends on how well we have modeled the distributions and also the number of simulations. There are many software available for Monte Carlo simulation. We will use Simular software, which is a free software. It is an emailware, which means that any application developed on this software should be shared with the other users on their website. Users can download similar software from the website as shown in the slide. So this is how the similar information looks like. And the Simular menu is available in Excel now. When you install Simular, you can see all the details of menu input variables, output variables, and all other menu commands under Simular software. Now let us consider an application example using Monte Carlo simulation. Strength of a unit is normally distributed with mean of 65 kg per millimeter square and a standard deviation of 5 kg per millimeter square. The unit is exposed to a stress value that follows Weibull distribution with a scale parameter of 20 kg per mm square and shape parameter of 1.5. The graph shown here is generated on Minitab for these two distributions. So we will now use similar software to perform the Monte Carlo simulation. We will do 10,000 simulations.
So in Excel, we use similar and we input first the information about the distribution parameters. The strength has got a mean of 65 and standard deviation of 5, and stress has got a shape parameter of 1.5 and scale parameter of 20. And now we use the similar menu with input variables, select the normal distribution, and we say strength in the defined name, choose mean as 65 and standard deviation as 5. And we paint the scale to identify it as an input parameter. Similarly, we choose for Weibull distribution and we use input variables in similar. We choose Weibull distribution now and define name as stress. And the alpha value is 1.5 and the beta value is 20. 20 is the scale parameter. Uses the Excel convention and now paint the scale as input parameter. Now we define the margin as strength minus stress with a normal Excel formula by pressing equal to and strength minus stress. But after completing this, we define this scale as the output parameter now, because that's the output that we want. So we call this as margin. We name it as margin and paint cell just to show that it's an output parameter and click apply. Now we are ready for the simulation in the similar software. So we click on the similar button and it will ask you for how many iterations you want, and we will choose 10,000. And just say okay and say simulate now. Now we'll have to wait until the simulation is complete as shown by the status bar above. You can see that the software is simulating. And after the simulation, we will see the complete results of the simulation. And based on the results, we will find out in how many cases out of 10,000 the value of margin has become negative, because the negative margin actually will mean that the stress is more than the strength in those cases. And based on the number of cases where it has shown the negative margin, we will estimate the reliability or the probability of failure. It is still simulating. We can see the status bar. It is nearly complete now. Once it is complete, we press OK to see the simulation results. And now we select the margin as the output parameter for seeing the results. Margin is the parameter, and we click on Compute Descriptive Statistics for the selected variable. It shows all the descriptive statistics and it shows the minimum, maximum, mean, variance, standard deviation, everything. It also shows the percentile values, but we will now click display histogram for the variable number one, and we are seeing a histogram of the difference, that is the margin, and we click on probability of less than zero to find out what is the probability of failure, and that's seen as 0.4% or 0.004.
That means the reliability will be 1 minus 0.004 or 0.996. per load application.
Now we look at the other options.
Display tornado chart.
It shows the relative impact of different variables. So the input variable strength and stress, how much is the impact on the margin. You can also see the impact with reference to correlation.
Now viewers can try this exercise on Monte Carlo simulation. The exercise is shown in the slide they can download Simular and try the exercise. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you found it worth watching. Please subscribe to Institute of Quality and Reliability channel if you want to watch more videos on reliability engineering, Six Sigma, and statistical quality control. Thank you.